This is the EWN Radio Network.
Welcome to Thriving Entrepreneur with your host, Steve Kidd, third-generation minister and business coach. Join Steve and his guests to get answers to your questions and help break through to the next level in your business.
This is Steve. Welcome to Thriving Entrepreneur. How are you doing today? Are you filled with thankfulness? For those of you that are listening live, I'm recording this Sunday just before Thanksgiving here in the United States. And regardless of what time of the year it is for you, I think it's important that we always take time to give thanks. And so I want to start off giving thanks for you, to you, for you. I'm really grateful for all of you that listen to the show. It just really helps me and inspires me that people listen, that people want to thrive in their life and business. And I just really appreciate you bringing me into your home, your car, your work, wherever it is that you listen to the show. Thank you very much. I'm very grateful and thankful for you. You know, there is a song, it's an older song actually, but you know, hey, I'm an old guy, so I know lots of old songs. Edwin Hawkins, Love Alive for Choir. For those of you that are familiar with some of Edwin Hawkins' music, amazing, amazing stuff he did during the course of his life. And on the Love Alive 4 album, is the recorded version. The live version is actually about 7 minutes longer. It's about 17 minutes total in length in the live video, but the recorded song is 10 and a half minutes, something like that. And the song is simply named Thank You. And I love the lines in the song because it talks about the fact that, you know, hey, it could be me. That could be outdoors with no food and no clothes. And I think that often we miss out on all of the things that are in our life. And it's easy to. It's really easy to let a day get past you without being thankful for the stuff from that day. I mean, think about all of the things good that happened today. It'd be really easy if I ask you, you know, what went wrong today? What are you struggling with today? It's so amazing as people that we are so in tune with the things that we have going wrong in our life. An old friend of mine, Ernie Villanueva, he's been on the show before. Ernie has a phrase, people go around looking for fault like there's money in it. And we do that in our own lives. We are so focused on what isn't that we miss what is. We miss, you know, the brilliance of a beautiful sunrise or even, you know, Kathy and I were talking about this the other day because it's rainy season here in Oregon. And there's a certain beauty to the rain falling, to that chill in the air. And depending on what kind of a person you are, obviously, with all of the authors that I've brought, you know, on the show and all of the different things we do with Bestsellers Guild, you know, obviously I love books, always have, been an avid reader since way back. I must have been 4 or 5 years old when I started learning to read and haven't been able to keep books out of my hand since then. You know, and so for us, one of the things that really appeals to us this time of the year is the thought of sitting in a comfy chair with your feet up in front of a fireplace, you know, and maybe a cup of hot chocolate with the little mini marshmallows. And that is something to be thankful for on the dreariest, rainiest days. We used to have, you know, some of you know, Kathy and I owned a Twilight fan store in St. Helens, Oregon. And those of you that don't, well, now you know too. And we used to always tease that on the sunny days, you know, the werewolves were out. And on the cloudy days, it was perfect vampire weather. And it just really does have to do with your perspective on things. Because whether you think you can or you think you can't, you're right. And whether you are emphasizing today on what is or what isn't, those are the things that are going to be important to you. Whatever you focus on grows. And that's part of what we want to, a big piece of what we want to talk about in this episode. Today's episode is going to be a little different. I'm actually going to spend the entire time trying to inspire you to Thanksgiving. Not the holiday. You know, it can mean great things for you. It can mean horrible things for you. You know, we've heard stories like, you know, Rodney talks about, you know, his father dumping the entire table of food onto the floor on a Thanksgiving and how tough that holiday was for him. You know, and there are wonderful memories of times with family and, you know, relatives, both ones that are still here with us and others that have passed that we have in our memory. You know, but I'm not talking about that specific day. I'm talking about Thanksgiving, truly thankfulness that just pours out of you. You know, I mean, the intro says it. So for those of you who are not Christians, I don't want to offend you, but there is some wisdom in a lot of books, regardless of your religious background. And there's a wonderful verse in the Old Testament. I think it's I think it's actually a proverb. I'd have to look it up, to be honest. But the verse says something along the lines of rejoice while it's called today. In other words, today is the only day you've got. Today is all that you have. Yesterday's gone. You can't get yesterday back. The mistakes that you made, the successes you had, the brilliant sunrise of yesterday is over. But today is here. The future, we want to have plans. You know, we've talked a lot on the show about goals and aspirations and living out your purpose and finding your purpose and things that you can do that are more focused on the future. But in the end, all you can do is what you can do today. It's often why when I'm working with authors, when we're trying to write their book, one of the questions I will ask them is, so what's something that a person can do, like right now, today? They can finish the book and they can put it down and immediately take action. Not something that you could do next week, next month, next year. What's something that a person could do right now? I encourage you. I challenge you. Let's start internally. What's something that you can do right now? Just right now. And then I'm going to give you the answer. Isn't that fun when, you know, you don't even have to come up with an answer on your own? And it's like when they give you open book tests, you know, and the back of the book has all the answers and you can just literally fill in the answers. I'm not sure how well you learn when you do that, but, you know, it's an easy way to be able to get through, you know, filling out a form pretty quick if they can tell you exactly what to fill in it. I'm going to give you the answer in this case. What you can do today is you can be thankful. Again, remember, just like I said here a few minutes ago, whatever you focus on grows. That thing that you put your mind to, you can do. Whatever you can conceive and believe, you can achieve. But you have to first conceive it, and then you have to believe it. You have to put your effort forward to it. So if you're putting all of your effort, now think about this for a minute. What if you're putting your effort to? If you're putting all of your effort towards identifying all of the problems, and I'm not saying there aren't times in business when we need to be clear on what's going wrong, because if you don't identify it, you can't fix it. But at some point, we have to ask ourselves, What are we focused on? You see, to have a after-event meeting with your crew and talk about what went right, what went wrong, to have staff meetings and talk with your staff about what are the things that we can improve on, what are the things that need to be changed. Those are important business practices, but those can't be the focus of your business. If all you ever focus on in your business is what's going wrong, what isn't working, then what you focus on grows. In other words, if the only thing you focus on is the money that isn't in the bank, the disrepair of the house, the problems with the children, those are the things that you're putting your energy into, but those are the things that you're also going to see keep getting worse and worse and worse. If you expect good things out of your children, I'm not telling you that they're not going to mess up, because we all do. Let's face it, we've all made mistakes in our own life. But if you believe in them, if you believe they can do more, that's the first step in them being able to do more. I mean, if you don't believe in them, who's going to? It's like I said to somebody just the other day, I had liked a post that I had done on Facebook. And somebody said, well, why did you like your own post? That seems kind of arrogant. And I'm like, no, think about it. If I don't like my stuff, why would anybody else want to? I should be the first person to like my post every single time. I like my posts because, I like what I was saying. I want you to like it too. I'm not just posting to Facebook, doing the podcast, helping people write their bestsellers for me, but I love what I do. I've told you before, this radio show is like my guilty pleasure. I love doing it. I absolutely adore it. I get to talk with amazing people. Every single guest I've had on the show is just so freaking amazing. I can't even believe it sometimes. Some of the people that I've gotten to be able to talk with. Matthew Knowles, Beyonce's dad. We had, besides the radio show, we had several conversations about different things that he had discovered over the course of his years managing Destiny's Child, and some really good, helpful advice on things that you can do in distribution, things to watch out for when you're making a big contract with a company like Walmart, or putting on events or different things like that. It was a fun conversation. And we talked about his book and we talked about his life and his business. And it was just really a lot of fun, both on the air and off. And that is just, it's mind-blowing, honestly, folks, to tell you how amazing it is to get to be able to do that. And I've had people on the show that I'm sure you've never heard of that have such amazing stories. I can't believe what some of these people have gone through. There are some books that I've got the inside track on because I helped them with their book writing session that we have coming up that I'm going to tell you, people, oh my gosh, when you hear some of these people's stories, you will never complain again. I promise you, there is one book that I know of that's coming out in December that when you read this book, you will be forever changed about how you think and feel about your own life and how difficult your life is. You see, and that's why I love what I do, why I love spending time at bestsellersguild.com, because I get to interact with amazing people who are changing their little corner of the world. Whether it be like Melanie, who's changing the life of those wonderful little girls that she raises. And she has other things that she does in business too. But her book was about you can be a good mom. And that discovery during that writing session of what an amazing, great mom she can be. Nafisa, great friend. Nafisa's book was amazing, but her life, that whole concept that she talked about on the show still blows me away. that concept of what kind of life do you want to live? Now, is your business actually encouraging and supporting that life? Or do you hate being on the road and yet you've created a lifestyle for yourself where you're traveling 300 out of 365 days? No wonder you're miserable. I loved that stuff. And the list just goes on and on of guests that we've had on the show that have shared insights from their years of experience and from their knowledge. And it's just freaking amazing to be able to do the show and to bring them to you and to share with you ways that you can thrive in your life and in your business. Because in the end, that's what Kathy and I want to do. It's why we named the website WeHelpYouThrive.com. That's what we're here for, is to help you thrive. We are going to take a quick commercial break, and then we're going to be right back with more Thanksgiving here on Thriving Entrepreneur.
I'm looking for a certain kind of woman, and I think you know her. She's an entrepreneur that is highly connected, successful, significant in her own industry, and considered the go-to woman in her community. She's received so much from so many women in business, she's ready to give back to others on their journey, lifting as she climbs. Hi, this is Sandra Yancey, and I'm the founder and CEO of eWomen Network. I'm looking to connect with the woman I've just described who lives in your community so that we might have a conversation about how eWomen Network's proven success system can provide her a platform to elevate her success and ability to support women in business. Our international community of managing directors are influencing the speed of success for women in business around the world. If that sounds like something that you want to be part of, or know someone we should talk with, send an email to managingdirector@eWomenNetwork.com. That's managingdirector@eWomenNetwork.com, and let's start the conversation.
You've heard Kathy and I talk about it. You've seen the workshops. You have watched as others of your friends have become a best-selling author, and now it's your turn. Let me ask you this. What would being a best-selling author do for your business? Over 80% of people surveyed said that they want to write a book, which means that if you're listening, you probably are one of those people. Now is your time, because you have a message that needs to be shared. That message is not for you. It's not for your ego. It is because it serves other people. Kathy and I are here to help you share your unique brilliance with the world. All you need to do is go to WeHelpYouThrive.com, check us out, and find out how you can be a best-selling author today.
Welcome back to Thriving Entrepreneur.
This is Steve. Welcome back. How are you doing? Are you thriving in your life and your business? Are you thankful today? You know, we've talked about it before on the show, but I was thinking about it over the commercial break. Your mind cannot distinguish between what you vividly imagine and what you've really done. And the first place that that shows up is that your mind believes anything that you say that follows the phrase, I am. So ask yourself for a second, what are you saying after the words, I am? And are they leading you, guiding you, directing you, bringing you to a newer, better, greater place in your life? I really hope so. I hope that you are finding thankfulness, that you're being thankful for all of the things in your life. So I want you to do something. All right. I want you to take a second. If you're driving, please do not text while driving. But if you happen to be sitting at a desk or someplace where you can pick up a piece of paper and a pen, what I want you to do is I want you to take just a minute here while you're listening, and I want you to list some things right now today that you're thankful for. And I'm going to help you because I'm going to prompt you for the next about a minute or so of some things that you maybe don't think of, but that you could be thankful for. So let's start off with an easy one. If you're listening to this show, then that means that you have ears and you can hear. Have you been thankful for the ability to be able to hear? Here's another really easy one. Again, if you're listening to the show, that means that you're alive. You woke up this morning. Are you grateful that you woke up this morning? Are you grateful for being alive? I said to somebody one time, you know, over the years and different things that I've, shown up in the world, I've had to help some people that were in dire circumstances. And every once in a while, not very often, but every once in a while, I've worked with somebody who was having suicidal thoughts or even tendencies. And I remember it came to me. I was young. I was probably 19 or 20. So forgive me if it was a little bit young adultish in the way that I said it. But the person was going on and on about how they just wanted to die and how they were going to kill themselves. And I finally looked at them and I said, you know, you keep talking about killing yourself, but that's based in the assumption that being dead, that whatever's on the other side of death, something or nothing, heaven or hell, or dirt, or whatever your belief system is, whatever's on the other side of death is better than what's on this side when you're still alive. That's a pretty huge assumption to make because you've never been there. What if it's worse? What if it isn't the answer, the solution to your problems? I heard a phrase, and honestly, I think it was on a TV show, but it was a quote from something else. And they were talking about all of the people that jump off the Brooklyn Bridge that on their way falling down from the bridge, they realize that everything that was bothering in them in life really isn't as important and that it all could be fixed and that none of it's as big of a deal other than the fact that they just jumped off the Brooklyn Bridge. And I think we tend to be that way sometimes in life. You know, we are so stuck in what's wrong that we stop thinking about what to be thankful for. And so again, on your list, do you have, hey, I'm glad I woke up this morning. I'm glad to be alive. I'm glad that my lungs work and that I can inhale and bring in oxygen and that I can exhale, that my body properly, converts oxygen and carbon dioxide and all of those kind of things. Are you grateful for, I remember one time, a long time ago, I was working with a youth group and they were like, we don't know what to pray about. And I said, well, how about you just start off with thank you for the trees? If that's the only prayer you could pray, just to be grateful for flowers and trees and the grass. Here at our house, we have a wonderful little puppy. Her name's Mocha. I'm sure I've probably mentioned her several times before. She's an absolute darling. She weighs, all of like 8 or 9 pounds. She's a little Yorkie. And I'm sure if you've been on my Facebook page, you've seen pictures of her. Little Miss Mocha. She's almost 3 years old now. I keep referring to her as a puppy, but she's a full dog now, okay? and she is just wonderful all the time, and it's a delight. It's one of those kind of things when Kathy and I are like, what can we talk about that was really happy? We always know that we can talk about little Mocha and be grateful for it. And a lot of you, I know you have pets in your lives too. And that's something that you can be thankful for. Thank you for this wonderful little creature that brings so much joy and delight into my life. For a lot of us, there's a lot of things that, are close to us. Our spouse. I am so grateful for Kathy. I could spend an entire show and you guys would probably get very bored, both bragging about as well as telling you all the things that I'm so grateful that she came into my life. The lottery winning just doesn't even touch how blessed I am to have her in my life. Such an amazing woman. Some of you don't know. Others of you have heard her recently tell her story. you know, Kathy struggled with agoraphobia, meaning that she had, a social anxiety issue that kept her from being able to go out into public. I mean, like at all. Like, there was a 3-month period where Kathy didn't leave the house, not even to check the mail. Now, flash forward to 2016. Kathy was on the main stage and did 2 breakout sessions besides that at Speak and Write in Atlanta in front of, you know, what was it, like 600 plus people. And, oh, you know, plus the 1,000, 1,200, whatever people that were on, on the live stream as well. What an amazing woman. And what an amazing transformation, all because she just keeps working on herself. And I could go on and on, but I think a lot of you feel the same way about your spouse, about the delight and the joy that they bring into your life. I know a lot of parents feel that way about their children, about all of the wonderful things that our kids have brought into our lives. How many of you, like us, have a bunch of quotes that the kids said when they were little that we still quote to this day? You know, they become part of the fabric of things that we say in life. I remember so many of the phrases that the kids have said over the years. Amber saying to her mom when one of her younger brothers was born, you know, "Mom, how can you take care of the baby? You don't even play with dolls." You know, and little Miss Maya, of course, running into the office where my dad and I were working on the company that we worked together in at that time, and looked at us just totally serious and said, "Do you guys have any naked people in here?" You know, and of course we didn't, you know, because we were working, but it's just the things that come out of their little mouths. And as they get older, they come up with other things that bless us. And then they get married, and then they make these incredible things called grandchildren. And those of you who don't have grandchildren yet, I can tell you, a grandchild is God's gift to you every single day, if for no other reason than all of the times that they drive their mother crazy. It's such a blessing to watch. And that sounds horrible, but it's so true. I love my grandkids, and I love watching the things that they put their mother through is really the truth. There's kids and grandkids that we can be grateful for, things that we can give thanks for, to give thanks with a grateful heart, for being alive, for our heart beating. So how does that list look? What kind of things did you get on there? What are you thankful for today? What are you thankful for over the course of the last week, the last month, the last year of your life? Kathy and I are so grateful for the 140 plus and growing number of best-selling authors that we've been blessed to be part of the journey of them becoming best-selling authors. It's so, so fun, so amazing, and absolutely incredible. That transformation that happens that day before when you're terrified. Oh my gosh. And we all go through it. It's like birthing a baby and you're afraid. And what if I'm that one person who doesn't become a best-selling author? What if people don't really like my book? What if they don't want to hear what I have to say? And then the next day comes and you transition into now and forever being a best-selling author. It is so great. It's so much fun for Kathy and I to be there, to share that journey with them, but also to then give them the message, hey, you're a best-selling author. We would love to give you that message. We would love for you to be our next best-selling author. I hope you'll consider it. We're going to take our next commercial break, and then we're going to be right back with more things to be thankful for here on Thriving Entrepreneur.
This is the EWN Radio Network.
Imagine the feeling of being seen as the go-to expert in your field and having that at no extra cost for marketing. Plus, having more time for your family, friends, vacations, and hobbies. You don't have to imagine anymore. Hi, I'm Kristen Baker, sales, money, and success coach, and I want to share my proven formula that I use to close over $100 million in sales. Go to KristenBakerCoach.com, that's K-R-I-S-T-E-N, BakerCoach.com, and access my free checklist called Turn 100 Leads into $20,000. Find out in less than 5 minutes if you've been sitting on a goldmine of ideal clients. Stop wasting time and money on sales and marketing methods that don't work. Start by going to KristenBakerCoach.com, download my checklist, and let's get started today.
You've heard Kathy and I talk about it. You've seen the workshops. You have watched as others of your friends have become a best-selling author. And now it's your turn. Let me ask you this. What would being a best-selling author do for your business? Over 80% of people surveyed said that they want to write a book, which means that if you're listening, you probably are one of those people. Now is your time because you have a message that needs to be shared. That message is not for you. It's not for your ego. It is because it serves other people. Kathy and I are here to help you share your unique brilliance with the world. All you need to do is go to WeHelpYouThrive.com, check us out, and find out how you can be a best-selling author today.
Welcome back to Thriving Entrepreneur.
This is Steve. Welcome back. All right, halfway through, you're either totally tired of hearing me talk, or hopefully my intent was to have you be inspired, to feel grateful and thankful for today, to rejoice while it's called today. I appreciate you being here. I am so thankful for every single one of you who listen to the show, whether it's your first time listening or whether you have heard every single solitary one of the episodes that we've done so far. Thank you. It means a lot to me. Like I said, the show is my guilty pleasure, but I do definitely like knowing that there are people out there who are listening, and I hope that in some little ways, and maybe even in some big ways, it's changing their lives. I love to be able to talk with people about their purpose. Did you know that you have a purpose in life? It's one of the things that I hope you're thankful for. We've been talking this whole entire episode about Thanksgiving, not about the day, not about the holiday, but about truly living thankful in every day of our life so that whenever you're listening to this show, maybe you're listening to it on Thanksgiving Day because you've got some free time in the afternoon after the lunchtime celebration, or, you know, maybe you're listening to it while you're cooking, or, you know, maybe you're listening to it live on Tuesday on the EWN radio network. Or maybe it's 3 years from now when I'm talking live and you're listening to it then. Thank you for listening. But now let's talk about what are you thankful for? And one of those things that I want to talk very specifically with you about now is your purpose. You've heard me say many, many times over that you are created for a purpose, that the world needs you. The world doesn't just want you. The world needs you. Our world is always a better place when each of us shows up as the best version of ourselves. And we want you to do that as well. So here's the next thing to think about, and that's your purpose. Something to be grateful, something to be thankful for is that purpose, that thing that you do so well that probably you've forgotten to be thankful for it. You've forgotten how impactful, how amazing your purpose really truly is. So I encourage you, take a minute, really think about that. You're uniquely brilliant. You were created for a purpose. You have an absolute specific reason to be here on this planet. And no, your specific reason is not because we need to keep the balance of oxygen and carbon dioxide on the planet stable. And so therefore, you or another person created. Your purpose is not that your parents couldn't keep their hands off of each other and so they made another child. No, you are here for a specific reason. You've heard me say over and over and over again, and at some point I got to have T.D. Jakes on the show. If any of you know him, please let him know. I would love to have him as a guest on the show. Thank you for the shameless plug. But T.D. Jakes says, and it's so amazing, it's just changed my world. T.D. Jakes really, really drove home how special and unique you are by saying, you know, God wanted you here on this earth so much that he didn't care what two people it took for you to come into existence. Just that you had to exist. You had to. It wasn't a, yeah, you know, it'd be nice if that person came around. No, there is a very specific, definite purpose that you are meant to fulfill. You specifically are meant to fulfill. And the first thing that we have to do is get our mind right around that. That means, first of all, we have to stop talking negative about ourselves. You know, I said earlier in the episode about everything that you say after the phrase I am, your mind has no choice but to just believe it. And so we need to start saying things about I am wonderful. I am special. I am uniquely brilliant. I am here for a purpose. I am going to impact the world. Because I promise you, big or small, no matter what you do, no matter how much you've convinced yourself that it's insignificant, it has a definite, drastic, dramatic impact on the world. Some of us have been called to speak to millions. There are those of us that our whole lives, people have been talking to us about the call on our lives, about the things that we're going to do, about shaping and molding the world. You know, in those times, like I have admitted many times over, that we become zombies and we're just out walking around, not fulfilling our place on the planet, but just settling for less than. Those times, the world is a little worse off because we didn't fulfill our purpose. But we absolutely are here for a specific reason. And when I discovered that I had to speak up, that I had to use my voice to share with people, I began to change the way that I approached the world, to think about what I was doing and how I could share with people. It's one of the reasons why, you know, this week I really wanted to talk to you specifically, just me, about Thanksgiving, is because I hold very dearly now that purpose in me to share with you and to help encourage you to fulfill and live out your purpose. But for other people, you know, their purpose may be seen in the encouragement that they give to somebody else. I remember one time I was talking to a gentleman, and he was talking about a young man that he had helped deal with the death of his parents and the fact that he was moving in with his grandparents. And honestly, I remember parts of the story, but the important part of the story wasn't who the person was. In fact, he said, I'd love to be able to tell you that, you know, and that person was the next president of the United States. He goes, that wasn't true. He said, but what that person was an amazing husband, a great father. He worked really hard at his business, you know, in the company that he worked for, at the job that he worked at. And the man really helped me see that those people whose lives we pour into, our children, our families, or a stranger on the street, you never know when that dollar that you gave to somebody has made a life-changing difference in their life. Even more simply than that, that smile and the how are you doing, I hope you have a great day, that you give to, like, for example, a cashier who's struggling, having a tough day. You may never know how drastic, dramatic, and impactful that simple, pleasant smile and conversation was in that person's life. Reminds me of the old story. A little boy was walking on the beach, and it was after a big storm, and there were just starfish all over the beach. And the little boy was running down the beach as fast as he could, picking up starfish and whipping them back into the ocean, picking them up and throwing them. And there were thousands upon thousands of them on this beach. And an older gentleman came up to him, and he stopped him for a second, and he said, "Hold on, what are you doing?" He goes, "I'm saving these starfish's lives because they're up too far here on the beach and they won't survive if they don't make it back into the water." And the older man looked at the little boy and he said, "But look at all these starfish. You can't possibly save all of them. What difference are you making, really? You'll probably only save a couple hundred out of the thousands of them that are up here on the beach." And the little boy looked at him and he said, as he threw the next starfish in the water, "To that one, it made all the difference." And that's what I really encourage you to think about today when you're thinking about your purpose. Sharing your gift with the world, to whomever, whenever you are sharing that gift, to that one, it made all the difference. Because you do have a purpose. You are here absolutely 100%, definitely guaranteed. You're here for a reason, for a purpose. The world needs you. It doesn't just want you, it needs you. In order for us all to live our best lives in the best place all of us can, we need to all be fulfilling that purpose that we were created for. We need to all be pulling the oars in the same direction. And it's really easy. It's just simply each of us fulfilling that purpose that we were made for. Can you do that? Now, like I said, the very first part of fulfilling your purpose is your mindset. And a lot of us, I raise in both hands and stand up, as Lisa Nichols would say, I've been there. We stop fulfilling our purpose. We give up. We make excuses. But now's the time to step away from the excuses and start really living in thanksgiving and gratitude for being exactly who you are. I can tell you right here, right now, I am so grateful that you exist on this planet. I'm so glad that you're listening to the show, and I'm so glad to know that by embracing what we're talking about here today, about Thanksgiving, that it's going to make a difference in your life, and that with you embracing the mindset of being thankful in all the things that are happening in your life, finding things to be grateful for, that you too are going to impact the world in a magnificent, marvelous, exciting way. And that, for each person that you touch, is going to, for them, make all of the difference. Now, that's something that you can be very, very thankful for today as we talk about Thanksgiving. Do you feel grateful for it? Are you glad that you're here? I know I'm glad that you're here, and I'm very thankful and grateful for you. We're going to be right back after this commercial break on Thriving Entrepreneur.
Hi, I'm Sandra Yancey, founder and CEO of eWomen Network. One of my mottos for business owners is, you can't do it alone. Whether you're in the startup stage of your business or you're scaling, you can't grow without relationships to provide support, wisdom, and new customers. eWomen Network is your home to connect with other women entrepreneurs who've been where you are or are experiencing the same challenges. We have chapters across the U.S. and Canada that have monthly events featuring our trademarked process called accelerated networking to ensure you get the contacts, resources, and leads you need to grow your business. And once you become a member, you get many benefits, including 2 one-on-one coaching sessions, unlimited access to our membership database, your own personal profile page, and discounts on products and services with our business partners such as UPS and American Express Open. Join the eWomen Network community and let us help you live your dream. For details, visit eWomenNetwork.com.
You've heard Kathy and I talk about it. You've seen the workshops. You have watched as others of your friends have become a best-selling author. And now it's your turn. Let me ask you this. What would being a best-selling author do for your business? Over 80% of people surveyed said that they want to write a book, which means that if you're listening, you probably are one of those people. Now is your time because you have a message that needs to be shared. That message is not for you. It's not for your ego. It is because it serves other people. Kathy and I are here to help you share your unique brilliance with the world. All you need to do is go to wehelpyouthrive.com, check us out, and find out how you can be a best-selling author today.
Welcome back to Thriving Entrepreneur.
This is Steve. Welcome back. You know, when I have guests on, we're always talking about how quick the time goes. And we're just like, wow, there's another hour that just went and we didn't even realize just how quickly it went by. And this episode has been no different. And I'm so thankful for you for being here with us this whole time. Now we need to be good teachers. We need to be good students, and we need to really come up with some things that we can do. We talked about it earlier, you know, the thing that I help people with in their book. So we want to talk about what is that thing that you could do, like right now, today, not tomorrow, because tomorrow's not here yet. What if you put off that thing you could do today, and for whatever reason, there was no tomorrow? That would be so sad. So what is the thing we can do today? So here it is. Hopefully, some of you made a list of the things that you're thankful for. Now I want you to spend some time really being in Thanksgiving. Again, sorry, no turkey involved in this particular Thanksgiving. I want you to be thankful for all of the things that are in your life. What are you thankful for? What are you grateful for? Now share them. Share that Thanksgiving with the world. How do you do that? Well, that's what social media is for. I want you to go onto Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, Instagram, Pinterest, YouTube, Periscope, Facebook Live, whatever kind of platform you are comfortable with and you use on a regular basis. I want you to go into that platform and I want you to share what you're thankful for today. And I don't want you to just share it. I want you to tag other people. I want you to, you know, so in Twitter, you're going to do hashtag, you know, in their their username. In Facebook, you know, there's the little thing at the bottom there, and you can tag the people, and so on and so forth. I want you to tag the different people that you're going to encourage and challenge them to be thankful as well. So I want you to share the top five things that you're thankful for today. Totally whatever you're thankful for today. It doesn't matter. If you can't come up with anything, well, then we've got a problem. And I'm sorry that I didn't inspire you properly in this particular episode, but I don't think that's an issue for any of you. I think more so probably what you're going to have a problem with is, picking only five things. But take the top five, and I want you to put them out there, and I want you to express them, especially if it's somebody that you're thankful for. You know, make sure to mention them by name, and then challenge three other friends to also share five things that they're thankful for today. And I want to see how wide we can get this to go around. So I'm going to ask you in each of these posts to please hashtag Thriving Entrepreneur. For those of you who aren't familiar with what a hashtag is, you know, it's when you hold down the shift button and you hit the number 3, it's what we used to call a pound sign. That's a hashtag in modern society. And I want you to hashtag Thriving Entrepreneur, so that we can see. I'd like to see it go around and around and around the world. I'd really, in a perfect world, love to see it never stop and have people just continue saying what they're thankful for and tagging three other people and saying, now share five things that you're thankful for, and have it just go around. We really need to be a society, a world that emphasizes and focuses on being thankful, being grateful for all of the things that we have in our life. Again, remember, as I talked about from the Edwin Hawkins song, you know, it could be us outdoors, no food, no clothes. And for the people that are outdoors, you know, it could be the people that are outdoors in America versus the people that are outdoors in India or the Philippines or China. Each of us, regardless of our state in life, has things that we can be grateful for, that we should be grateful for, and that I hope that you will be thankful for, that you will spend your days in thanksgiving. One of the things that I am so thankful for, and I've said it several times, is the family that we've created at bestsellersguild.com. Kathy and I intended it to be a community where bestsellers could come together and really truly share their stuff with the world. It's really become a family. As we got together at Speak and Write in Atlanta and began to meet all of the people in person for the first time, we began to see them interact with one another and hear stories about how they call each other and they talk to each other, support and encourage one another as they're going through their book writing process, as they're promoting their book afterwards, but also just in their general day-to-day lives. It really, truly has become a family there at bestsellersguild.com. It's a free group that you can join. We know that like 81% of the people in the world want to be best-selling authors. So you probably, if you're breathing, are one of those 81% of the people in the world. So you would belong there as part of our group to help you thrive in life and business through sharing your message with the world. And not just sharing it, not just writing a book, but being a best seller. Doesn't that feel great? Doesn't just even the concept of I'm a best-selling author, doesn't it feel good? I mean, I know I could bring a whole bunch of people on the show. I know, because I've done it on the show, those of you that have listened to past episodes. and they talk about how amazing and life-transforming it is for them to be a best-selling author. And we want you to be too. So join us at bestsellersguild.com. We've been talking this whole entire episode about Thanksgiving, about the art, really, of being thankful, about the necessity of being thankful, about how our purpose is so amazing. And it's something that we need to not take for granted, but to really, truly be thankful for the people that are in our lives, but also for our own life, for that unique, wonderful, special gift that is our own life. You're so amazing. You know, true humility is a right perspective of yourself. It's not about, beating yourself with a cat of nine tails, whipping yourself into submission. That actually is an outcome of a type of arrogance when we have to diminish ourselves in order to seem humble. True humility is a right perspective of yourself. And you are freaking amazing. And you need to share that with the world, because the world needs your amazingness to shine through so that we can all live and thrive in our life and business. So I encourage you to begin to celebrate you, to be thankful for your existence here on this planet and for your gifts that you bring to the world, because there is no one else that can be you. You are unique as each individual snowflake. You too are a unique, wonderful, empowering individual that is created to make impactful, dynamic, wonderful changes in the world. And so now we need to all embrace doing that and being that and thriving in our life and business, to live day to day, every day as we go through life, thankful for our life, thriving in our life and our business. Can you do that for me? I hope you will go out, hashtag Thriving Entrepreneur on Facebook, Twitter, whatever, and you will share 5 things that you're thankful for today, and you will tag at least 3 people. Now, you can go crazy. Tag 300 people. That's fine. Thanksgiving is not something that we need to hold back on. It's something that we can give out to the whole entire world. Because remember, you are uniquely brilliant. You were created for a purpose. The world needs you. Kathy and I are here to help you live every single day of your life as a thriving entrepreneur. Until next time, have an amazing, thankful, grateful, wonderful, impactful, dynamic week.
Thanks for listening to Thriving Entrepreneur today. If you want to get your question answered, send an email to questions@wehelpyouthrive.com. We look forward to you joining us again next time.
You've heard Kathy and I talk about it. You've seen the workshops. You have watched as others of your friends have become a best-selling author. And now it's your turn. Let me ask you this. What would being a best-selling author do for your business? Over 80% of people surveyed said that they want to write a book, which means that if you're listening, you probably are one of those people. Now is your time, because you have a message that needs to be shared. That message is not for you. It's not for your ego. It is because it serves other people. Kathy and I are here to help you share your unique brilliance with the world. All you need to do is go to wehelpyouthrive.com, check us out, and find out how you can be a best-selling author today.